have a dream, that's all I need. I'll make it happen with some work and belief.
How do I become GDPR compliant? It's an interesting question, but I think I should have changed it. How do I become and stay GDPR compliant? You understand what I mean? Because if you look at the previous video or the previous question that we answer, is that you may be today GDPR compliant, but it doesn't mean you're GDPR compliant tomorrow. You understand what I mean? So what I mean by that is, when you want to be GDPR compliant, you do a privacy impact assessment. So PER, I call it PER, people call it DPR, doesn't matter, it's the same. Data Protection Impact Assessment, doesn't matter. Data Protection Impact Assessment, Privacy Impact Assessment, same. The way how you do the assessment can be different. But keep in mind, PER is almost the same as DPO, in my opinion. Yeah, it's just the test is different. So just the test, the assessment can be different how you do that, but most time it's the same, because you need to make sure that you meet the requirements of the GDPR in this case. So how do I become GDPR compliant? When you are developing a product, let's say we are developing a product, we have phase one, phase two, phase three. Every time if I start with a phase, I will make sure I do a PER. Why is that? You make sure that you meet the requirements of the GDPR. And it can save you a lot of money, because if you do it here at, this is phase one, phase two, phase three. If you do it here and you need to change something big, it can cost you a lot of money. And most time people don't do that. They'll be like, you know what? I don't care. Let's continue with the project. So if you do it here, you can save a lot of money. You can discuss a lot of things. Yeah. And even when you have a phase four, let's say we have a phase four here. Let's say we have a phase four here. That means the project will go into the company. You need to make sure that you meet the requirement of the GDPR. So when it goes to the company, make sure you meet the requirement of GDPR. Let's say someone built a website for you. You have a design way, you have a development way, and you have a test way, and then you want to go to the company. Need to make sure that in all those processes you need to that you are meeting the requirement of GDPR. Doesn't have to be that long. When you do it once, the second time it will be shorter, third time it will be shorter, because you only need to change minor things. But if you do it at the end, that can be a problem. I hope you understand what I mean. So how do I become GDPR compliant? The question should be, how do I become and stay GDPR compliant? Do it every time. Do every time data protection. PER, privacy impact assessment, or data protection impact assessment, doesn't matter how you call it. Do it every time when there is something, and then you can see I meet the requirements or not. It's that simple. And when you do that, it can save you a lot of trouble. So, and you can save a lot of money, because when the authority find out there's something wrong, they will come after you, and you don't want that. And when there's a data breach, you have a problem. So how do I become that? Just make sure you do a PER or DPR. And if you have done that, make sure that you have a DPO. It can be someone that knows a lot about the privacy impact assessment, like us, for example. I'm not promoting us, but just showing. And they do it remotely. They keep track of everything that's happening in your company and advise you beforehand. And it's better to prevent something than heal something. Keep that in mind. When data is on street, data is on street. You cannot take it back. It's like data's on street, other people will have access to it. So when there's a data breach, people will have access to this information. What are you going to do? Make sure you meet the requirements of GDPR. So if you have question about this or anything, just go on the Law Center, the Discord. You can ask me the question directly. And if you like this information, was it interesting, was it useful, buy me some coffee. $3. This information is useful for you. Buy me coffee. $3. Okay. And if you want to know what kind of services we provide, just press legal services and you will see what kind of services we provide. And again, question or you want a specific service, go in the Law Center, ask me directly or one of our co-workers. And if you want to support the stream, just press donate now and you can support the stream.
I have a dream, that's all I need. I'll make it happen with some work and belief. Know what I want, so I'll take it on. I've made mistakes, but mistakes make you strong. Let's break it down for a minute. I want the crown, I'm gon' get it. You hear me loud, man, I'm winning. Yeah, Charlie Sheen will be grinning.